just bear with us. When I have so many kids like this, it's always a beautiful thing. Hallelujah. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. I can need some smiles, man. Praise ye the Lord. Oh, no, we're not there yet. Praise ye the Lord. Maybe you are saying that to Royal. But we need it to a praise to the King of Kings. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Praise the Most High God.
Hallelujah.
Hey, Papa, praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Mama, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Sister, praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Beauty, praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You know, there's a song we say. Say hallelujah is a heavenly language. How many of you remember that song? You remember? I thought it was before your time. Praise ye the Lord. Hallelujah. Today is Sunday the 22nd. We're going to have a ball. The kids have been learning a lot of stuff. Just bear with us. You know, kids are at their level. We have to break it down to, you know, elementary level. So those of us that are mathematicians and know a lot of geography and atomic physics and all that stuff, just put it aside for me, okay? Now I'm going to hand over the mic to my able assistant who's going to guide us through this procession. Her name?
My name is Precious, and today we will be the first song we'll be singing is called Complete in Him, and the scripture is Titus chapter 3, verse 5, not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy he saved us by the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Ghost.
Much. Without Jesus, we can do nothing. We can absolutely do nothing. Let us welcome His Highness. the commander-in-chief, the Lord of the armies of heaven, before whom heavens bow, the earth quakes at the sound of whose name? And who is that? Could you please stand up and welcome His Highness? He that is greater than the greatest. The great is made great because He made them great. And the greats that He made great, they are no more. But He's alive forevermore. Can somebody say amen? And He is alive forevermore. That is why we are complete in Him. Muhammad is dead. Krishna is dead. All of them were idols. But we thank God that we have a God who is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Father, we exalt You this morning. We join the hosts of heaven to lift You up on top where You belong, as King and the Kingmaker, as the Senator and the Senators of Senators, as the Governor and the Governor of Governors. We thank You, Lord, because without You, we are nothing. There's no rising up, there's no sitting down, there's no eating, there's no walking, there's no talking, and there are no dirty dishes. Father, Lord, at the sound of Your voice, the angels that excel in strength and power, they obey Your command. You said it for the ordinance of the heavens, and it's still the same from the beginning. Thank You, Father, Lord. We commit this fellowship into Your special care, that You will be seen, that man may be reduced to nothing, in the name of Jesus. Lord, that these kids, as they minister to us, You said, let little kids come unto Me, for such is the kingdom of heaven. In their simplicity, we do our best to nurture them. We commend them unto Your grace. Thou that's able to keep that which is placed in Your hand, keep through Thy name, in the name of Jesus Christ. Because I see among them evangelists, prophets, and teachers, leaders of their generation, in the name of Jesus. Ambassadors of a kingdom that rules over all kingdoms. Father, as it's been spoken upon these children, let it come to pass in the name of Jesus. That they will be pillars in the kingdom of our God in the name of Jesus. They will speak to the enemies at the gate in the name of Jesus. That the enemy will not afflict them. Thy son of wickedness will have no part in their lives, according to My word, in the name of Jesus. Thank You, Father. Should we have any praise, we give You all the praise and all the glory. In Jesus' matchless name, we pray and receive it with thanksgiving. And everybody said? Amen. Everybody said? Amen. You know, we do the best we can. And we allow the Holy Spirit to take over. Amen. Maybe I should stay back here. Like I said, these kids have been, sometimes it's a little challenging when you have so many kids and some show up and some don't show up all the time. So we have to keep going over and over. We had started in the book of Genesis, and we've been going through the scriptures. Most of everything we'll be doing today will be focused around the book of Leviticus. And we go back and forth. So it's very elementary, very rudimentary. Bear with us, we are just children. Amen? I said, bear with us, we are just children. Hallelujah. I would like the kids to stand up. Our first hymn that we're going to sing is titled, Bless the Lord, O My Soul. Bless the Lord, O My Soul. And let me introduce the kids one by one first. Give me a second here. I want you to give us your first name and tell us how old you are. Is that fair enough? Pass that mic. You start first and then pass the mic.
My name is Jay and I'm 9 years old.
My name is Ruth and I'm 8 years old.
My name is Nathaniel and I'm 6 years old.
How did you?
Six. Nathaniel.
Nathaniel. He said Nathaniel. He's a gentleman.
My name is Abigail and I'm 5 years old.
Bless your heart.
Michael. Michael.
I know. But they don't know. They got to know who you are. Michael. How old are you?
I don't know.
How old are you?
Five.
You're five. All right. Bless your heart, sonny boy. All right. You got a mic there?
My name is Tochi and I'm 9 years old.
My name is Joseph and I'm 10 years old.
My name is Ruby and I'm 10 years old.
All right. On this side, I have this young man. He will slay anybody with his smile.
My name is Chidi and I'm 6 years old.
My name is Michelle and I'm 7 years old.
My name is Ronald and I'm 5 years old.
My name is Oyo and I'm 6 years old.
My name is Christiana and I'm 7 years old. Seven.
What's your name?
Christiana.
Christian. No. Christiana. All right.
My name is Nathan and I'm 7.
My name is Peculiar and I'm 9. My name is Peculiar and I'm 9 years old.
Did you hear her name? Huh? What's your name?
Peculiar.
She's a lady. All right.
My name is Nanya and I'm 9 years old.
My name is David and I'm 13 years old.
My name is Precious and I'm 12 years old.
Thank you. So we have, this our chief vocalist here. What's your name, honey?
Desire.
Desire. How old are you?
Four.
She's four, but she's as bold as a lion.
What?
I'm serious. You got to hear her sing. Give her the mic. She'll turn this house upside down for Jesus. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So the song they're going to sing, and oh, my goodness, I have on the keyboard my granddaughter, the one and only, Joelle Ann.
I'm Joelle, and I'm 12 years old. I'm Joelle, and I'm 12 years old.
She's on the keyboard. Hallelujah. She's a genius. She plays several instruments. You'll find out. You'll find out today. Oh, I got my baby over here. Come here, mama. Come here, sweetheart. Ah, I was missing you so much yesterday. Who took you away from me? Who did? Mommy? Was it mommy or daddy? Or is it grandpa? Grandpa? Don't worry. Oh, it's grandma's fault. We blame grandma for it. That's what these men do. They blame grandma for it. Okay. Come here. Come here. Come and sit down here, mama. Yeah, sit down. Okay. Oh, and I saw my young pastor come in. I missed him yesterday, too. Do I remember your name, my dear grandson? Do you remember me? What's your name?
Ikenna.
How old are you?
10.
You are 10. And did we remember your name? What's your name?
Keoma.
Keoma. She's so gentle. How old are you?
7.
She's 7. Oh, my goodness. I get excited about this around these kids. Praise you, the Lord. So on the keyboard, you give us a chord, and then we'll take it from there. All right, praise the Lord.
Bless the
like to hear kids sing. It's like a heavenly choir. Amen? It really does. It's so innocent, so beautiful, so pure. I think that's why God said, let children come unto me. You weep a child right now, you scold him, you come back and hug you. Amen? I love it. I love it. That's why Jesus said, those of us that are older, he said, be of understanding. Be not to have malice. He said, in children, in malice, be ye children. Amen? Ephesians chapter 4. If I quoted that right, praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. So we're going to ask them a few questions just to see if they remember some of the stuff we have been talking about. That's the whole purpose. You know, we could do a lot of things, ideas and stuff, but the Word of God, nobody can take it away from them. It's the weapon for which they were going to fight the enemy. Amen? It's the sword of the Spirit. Amen? Or somebody is saying, Peter, you got it wrong. I said the Word of God is the sword of the Spirit with which they will confront the enemy when the time comes. That's why it says, teach the child the way it should go. And what do we should teach? We got to use the Word of God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Now, the first question I think I'm going to ask is this. Do we have to keep some or all of God's commandments? Do we have to keep some or all of God's commandments? You see, previously they've been talking about the Ten Commandments, Book of Exodus, and back, fought like that. There are so many laws, so many commandments. So my question to Tochi, you see here? Is Tochi here? Do we have to keep some or all? You have a mic there, right? Okay, what's your answer to that question? And you have to give me a Bible reference, right? You're going to give me a Bible reference? Okay, tell me first, what do we have to keep all or some of God's commandments?
All.
He said all. Was it? Do you have a Bible reference?
Yes.
Okay, show me. Tell me. Tell us. It's a young. I got a young preacher here. Ain't going to stay back there and preach. Praise you, the Lord. Come on, boy.
Matthew chapter 18, verse 18 to 20.
Give him a second here. God help him. He just got himself a new Bible. Praise you, the Lord. So they're all sticking together. All right.
It's right here.
Oh, see? I needed my glasses to see that. All right. You want to tell us?
Leviticus chapter 22, verse 31. Before shall ye keep my commandments and do them, I am the Lord. Therefore shall ye my commandments and do them, I am the Lord.
Where in the Bible, this question will go to David. I know the young man is a genius. Where in the Bible can you find the Ten Commandments? Where in the Bible? Do you have a mic there? Where in the Bible can you find the Ten Commandments?
In Exodus 20.
Okay. Is that right? Is that right? You got it? You're confident about that? Give him a hand clap. Praise you, the Lord. Now, the next question goes to my keyboardist, Joel Ann. Can you list all the Ten Commandments? You can.
Number one, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with thou shalt. There's only one God. Thou shalt not make any idols. Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord in vain. Thou shalt keep the Sabbath day. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not covet. Thou shalt not bear false witness.
Thank you, Joellen. Kids, please don't drop that mic, please. Don't drop the mics. Thank you. Thank you, Joellen. Now, this next question pertains to a lot of things that happen in our society today, and we thought it's important that the kids get a hold of it. What? Now, the Bible, this question goes to Nathan. Say, thou shalt not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. Nathan, is he here? Can you explain this to us, please? Say, thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God. What does that mean?
That means, like, you shouldn't use God's name in any, like, bad words or curse words. Like, use God in any type of word, like the F word and the B word. And the reference is Exodus 20, verse 3 and 5. Thou shalt have no other God before me, and thou shalt not bow down thine to them, or nor serve them, for I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous vis God.
Thank you. Now, what does the Bible say about making anything or anyone your idol? This question would go to Nanye. You got a mic there?
It says here in Exodus 20, verse 3, thou shalt not have any other gods before me. It also says so in Exodus chapter 20, verse 5. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them. For I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous God.
Thank you. Now, Michelle, is Michelle here?
Yeah.
Are there only 10 commandments in the Bible? Are there only 10 commandments? Put the mic.
Yes.
There are only 10 commandments? Okay. Let me ask Ronelle, are there only 10 commandments in the Bible?
No.
How many commandments are there in the Bible? What? Oh, thank you. Give him a hand clap. So if we have to obey all these commandments, if we are living the Old Testament, it'd be a whole lot of a job. But we thank God we are not there. Praise ye the Lord. With all these commandments, Jesus Christ summarized all these commandments in Leviticus, Deuteronomy. He summarized them for us into just two. I'm going to ask Joseph first, what summarized them for us, the two that God summarized all these thousands of thou shalt not, thou shalt not. Where's Joseph? Are you there? All right. Could you give him the mic? Thank you.
Jesus said unto him, thou shalt love thy
Lord. So, no, you got to give me, summarize for me first before you tell us where you got it from. Tell us in your own words, okay?
Love the Lord with all your heart, and all your mind, and all your soul.
What's the second one?
To love your neighbor.
Awesome. Now, what is your Bible? What is your Bible reference? Because it's not, Pastor Peter didn't say it. Auntie Grace, you say it? We don't want them to quote us. They can quote the author. Amen? So where did you find that?
Matthew 22, 37 through 40.
Can you read it to us?
Jesus said unto him, thou shalt love the Lord with all thy God, with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself.
Thank you.
On these two commandments hang all the law and prophets.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm going to have to confirm this from your neighbor next to you there. Ruby, can you confirm what he just said in your own words? And tell me if what you quoted is right. Give her the mic. Thank you. So tell us, in your own words, all these several commandments, Jesus summarized them into two. Give it to us in your own words, and then let me see if you have another scripture other than what he quoted. Okay, go ahead, Ruby.
Jesus summarized these. Jesus summarized these commandments into two, and they're love your neighbor as yourself, and love God with all your heart, all your soul, all your strength, and all your.
What's your reference? Praise the Lord. Did you forget it? In your Bible, you can find it. You do. What's your name?
Kioma.
Oh, come on, give it to me. Help out here, read it. She has it.
Jesus said unto him, thou shalt love the Lord, thy God, with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all their mind. What this is the first and great commanders, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love their neighbors as themself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Thank you, sweetheart. Where were you reading from? Tell me, mama.
Matthew 22.
Okay. Verses.
Verse 37 through 40.
Thank you. I'll tell you what. Last session I gave the kids a memory verse, and boy, was she outstanding. She was outstanding. Thank you very much, Kioma. Now, the next question I want to ask Chidi. Is Chidi here? Who's your neighbor? Who's your neighbor, Chidi?
Everyone.
Is that everyone? Hallelujah. See, he's smiling. That he gives you a killer smile there. Let me ask, who else can I ask this question? Maybe they have of a different opinion. Nathaniel. Is Nathaniel here? Who's your neighbor?
Everybody.
Everybody. Is she your neighbor?
Yes.
Is she your neighbor? Yes. Everybody's your neighbor. Hallelujah. Praise ye the Lord. Let me see. Desire. Tell me, who's your neighbor? Who's your neighbor?
Everyone.
Oh, give her a hand clap. She got it right. Am I your neighbor?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Am I your neighbor?
Yes.
Awesome. Praise ye the Lord. So everybody, we should love all our neighbors as ourselves. Praise ye the Lord. The next question, is Abigail in the house? Where is she? Where's Abigail? Oh, did I call you Michelle? Who did I call Michelle? I mixed their names together. So Abigail, this question goes to you. Is swearing okay? Is it okay to swear?
Never.
What did you say?
Never.
She says never. Praise you, the Lord. Correct. Thank you very much, sister. Now, David, you're going to have to help her. Give us a scriptural reference for that. David, do you have a mic there? See, some of our kids, they know this stuff, but they can't read yet. So David's going to help us. Tell us where you're referencing, okay? Thank you.
I'll be reading James chapter 5, verse 12. But above all things, my brethren, swear not, neither by heaven, neither by earth, neither by any other oath. But let your yea be yea, and your nay be nay. Lest ye fall into condemnation.
Praise ye the Lord. What does yea and nay, what does that mean?
When you want to talk, you should not like use like swear. Okay. Instead, just be like your day be day and your he be he, like something like that.
So that's old colloquial English. What is yea? What is yea? What does it mean? Eh? Help him out. What does yea mean?
Yea is yes and nay is no.
No, okay. So let your yes be yes and your nay be nay. Nothing beyond that. So we don't break God's laws. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. All right. Royal. Is Royal in the house? Royal,
If you break one law, is it just that one law you have broken? If you break one law, is it just one law you've broken?
No.
You've broken the one?
All
of them. Give Lord a hand clap. Give Ronnie a hand clap. I got a royal hand clap. All of them. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Now, I'm going to have to ask Ronnell. Where's Ronnell? Where's Ronnell? Ronnell, are you there? Oh, my first grandson. Can you tell me which scriptural reference that I know you had memorized? Yeah. Which one was that?
2:10.
Say that again.
James 2:10.
Okay, tell me about it. Tell me what it says.
For whosoever shall keep the whole law, but yet defend the one point is guilty for all.
Where can you find that? Huh?
James 2:10.
Praise ye the Lord. Whosoever offends in one, spend it in all. So we try to establish the word of God with these keys. All right. This was the original question for Keoma. Who became the fulfillment of the law for all of us? Who became the fulfillment of the law for all of us?
Jesus.
Hallelujah. She says Jesus. Amen. Give her a hand clap. Praise ye the Lord. It looks very simple, but we keep it simple for the kids. Hallelujah. Ruth. Who became the fulfillment of the law?
Jesus.
You sure?
Yes.
You have a script. Who is going to help both of them out with a scriptural reference? You can. Awesome. You have a mic there. Tell us.
So, 2 Corinthians 5, verse 21. For he hath made him to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Do you have another reference? You have another reference, David? Come on. Let me see what you, tell me what you, which one you're going to read.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 17. Think now that I have come to destroy the law or the prophets. I have not come to destroy but to fulfill.
Amen. He who knew no sin became sin so that we could become the righteousness of God. Amen. Thank you, David. Now, the next question goes to all these kids, to all of them. I'm going to ask a few of them. If you are living in the times of the law, for all the sins and all the laws you broke in 1 year, how many goats or lambs or turtle dove will your mommy and your daddy have to buy? Let me ask some of them. How many?
More than a million. More than a million. More than a million.
How about you?
Over 600.
In 1 year. How about you, Mama?
Maybe 5 per year.
She says only 5 per year. Okay. How about you?
1 year.
1 a year. One. Okay. He, 1 a year. He's still very innocent. How about you?
Four.
Oh, she's a good teenager. She's getting there. How about you, Jia?
18,000 million.
18,000 million. Thank you. How about you?
10,000.
10,000. You're getting there. Ha! How about you?
10,000.
10,000. And you?
60.
60. You got a 60,000. Oh, it says 60,000. I thought it said 60. I'm going to say she's got a, we got a young prophet here, man. How about you?
More than 100,000.
How about David? Take the mic there. How about David?
10 million.
Okay. Oh, sorry. I meant to say Joseph. Tochi?
Let's just say like a 5,000.
He's a man. He has to be calculating this thing. Yeah? Now, how would there be enough money left in the bank? Who said a million? Would there be money left in the bank for a mommy to pay the bills and the mortgage? Huh? Would there be enough money?
No.
Would she be able to pay the light bill?
No.
Huh?
No.
Thank God. Hey, Auntie? Auntie Princessa? What do you think? You have no more money. Thank God. Jesus Christ, he came to die once. Hallelujah. That is great. That is great. And that is favor, unmerited favor for all of us. Praise ye the Lord. Now, we, like I said, we went through the book of Leviticus. There's been a lot of stuff we've been going through and going back and forth. Now, in Leviticus chapter 26, this question would go to, let me see. Oh, Brian is not here. Okay, maybe Joel Ann can help us out. Joel Ann, the book of Leviticus is one we went through a little extensively. Tell us, it looks like it's divided into certain sections and all that. So, could you help us out?
Leviticus chapter 26 is divided into three sections. The first section is what will happen to us if we obey God's word, which is in verses 3 to 13. Verses 14 to 39 talks about what will happen if we disobey God's commandments. And verses 40 to 46 talks about what we can do to confess our sins.
These kids encourage a lot of us, including myself, to go and read the Bible. It's true. It's just the truth. You know, you think as a child, kids, but you got to check this since I make sure it's good. Thank you very much, Joel Ann. I appreciate that. Now, yeah. Is there, where's Jia? She went to the bathroom. Oh, okay. Who's going to help out while she's gone? There was a memory verse that we learned also, we learned as a song. If we confess, any of you remember that, where that memory verse is? You do? All of them do. Jia, you remember? Kelma, can you open the Bible and tell me where it's at? Huh? If you're going to tell me where it's at, you got to open the Bible. You got your hands up still? Okay. You, go ahead.
John chapter 1.
You open it. If your hands, you have your hands up, you got to open it. You remember? Okay, where is that found?
First John chapter 1, verse 8 and 9. If we say that we have no sins, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive.
Is that correct?
Yes. Okay. From all unrighteousness.
He said he didn't read the whole verse. You got to hear the whole thing. He's got to teach you the whole thing. Go ahead, buddy.
And just to forgive our sins and to clean us all from our righteousness,
Thank you, buddy. He had to finish reading that, you know, so you will know it. So if I come to ask you, Sister Pearl, if I ask you, Sister Pearl, you have to quote it correctly like he did. Uh-huh. Perfect. So he wanted you us to get it right. Huh, buddy? We have to get it right. Did you know it too? Did you remember? Okay, tell us. So that those of us that didn't hear him would hear it.
1 John 1:9 says, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right. All of you stand up. It's so easy sometimes you remember this thing by a song. So they learned a song that bring it to their memory when they need it. Am I right? Okay. Give us the chord. Thank you. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Now, you have to give them a few minutes. They have to say that, take care of that technical issue. Thank you. The next, now that they have confessed, you've confessed your sin, and God is forgiving you, you are now enlisted in God's army. Yes or yes? You have become a soldier in the battlefield. Amen? Is that true? Come on. When you've confessed your sin and you've repented and asked Jesus into your life, you have become what?
A soldier in the battlefield.
Thank you, Mom. You have become what?
A soldier.
Where?
At the battlefield.
So you got your sword of the spirit to go pow, 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 pow. Right? Yes. To deal a blow to the devil, give him a black eye. Huh? Right?
Yeah.
Okay, so they have enlisted in the battlefield and they're going to give the devil a black eye. Praise ye the Lord. They have a song they want to sing to us. Is somebody calling me? Is somebody calling my name? Is somebody calling my name? Okay, David. Come on, David. They're going to move a few things around. So since they're enlisted in God's army, who's got the other?
Thank you.
Ago, they heard the story of the little mama who was praying, Lord, I'm barren this several years. Please give me a son. And if you give me this son, please, I'm going to dedicate him to you. And Samuel was born. And Samuel heard the Lord calling. He didn't know, say, Master Eli, who's calling my name? I hear somebody calling me. And so the Lord is calling this once. I guarantee you, to their generations you see sitting here, evangelists, pastors, in the name of Jesus, because they yielded to the call. The song will stay with them. Who's calling me? He said, Lord, I'm ready. Here am I, send me. Praise ye the Lord. Who is calling your name? Oh, Jesus is calling your name. Oh, Jesus, if you call their name, they will answer a billion times. Who is calling your name? Oh, Jesus is calling your name. Jesus, if you call their name, they will answer a billion times. Hallelujah. Praise ye the Lord. That is all. That is all it's about. You know, the Lord promised a revival. And I told these kids, a revival unlike with the light, unlike the earth has ever seen. And these kids will lay their hands on hospital rooms where they're sick. When the Lord says you cannot pray for somebody, these kids will lay their hands on the walls of the hospitals, and the dead will not stay dead. In the name of Jesus, the mortuaries will be empty at the sound of their voice. The truth, he said, I will restore. He said, I will restore that which the cankerworm, the caterpillar has eaten. The armies and all the crap, excuse my French. This is the generation. Hallelujah. This is the generation. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Because they will hear the voice of the Master saying, I need you. And they will hear the call in the name of Jesus. Christina. In Leviticus chapter 26, there's a verse in there that teaches us the power of united prayer. Oh my goodness. Is Christina here? Is she here? Is Christina here? Anybody seen Christina? Where is she? Are you here? I can hear you.
Yeah.
You're here. Okay. Tell us what scripture is that?
Leviticus 26, verse 8. And five of you shall chase 100, and 100 of you shall put 10,000 to fight, and your enemies shall fall before you.
Praise ye the Lord. You know, we teach these kids to pray, to pray, to pray, pray for one another. And as they do it, things start to happen. The sick will not stay sick. Now, is there any other reference for praying for one another that we refer to? Do you remember that? Anybody? Tochi, do you remember? Is there any other Bible reference that you learned that teaches you about praying for one another? Do you remember? You do? You want to tell me about it? Okay, tell us. Tell us about it. Yeah. Yeah. Bring your Bible.
Somewhere. So I'm reading in Matthew chapter 18, verse 20. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there I am in the midst of them.
Thank you. That was Matthew chapter 18, verse 20. Does any other person have another reference? I know he has. He knows a whole lot, that young man. So anybody remember any other reference? Huh? Let's have somebody else give us another reference. I have first. You got the mic there? Okay, go ahead. Give us a reference.
James chapter 5, verse 16. Confess your fault one to another and pray one for another that ye may be healed. That effectual fervent prayer of righteousness man availeth much.
Okay, you want to read it for him? Read that scripture again. Thank you, Noye. Thank you, David. Tell us where you're reading from.
James 5:16. Confess your faults to one another and pray one for another that ye may be healed. The effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much.
Praise ye the Lord. Thank you very much, Noye. Now, the next question goes to Joel Ann. Which parts, which verse in Leviticus 26 references God living in and with us? Joel Ann?
Leviticus chapter 26, verse 12 and 13. And I will walk among you and will be your God, and you shall be my people. I am the Lord your God, which brought you forth out of the land of Egypt, that ye shall not be their bondsmen. I have broken the bands of your yoke and made you go upright.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Give a hand clap. See, like I told you, we are in the Old Testament, and we gradually shift and give references back and forth like that. Praise the Lord. Now, is there any other reference in the Bible? This question goes to Ruby. That tells us God living with us and in us. Ruby.
My verse is from John chapter 14, verse 16 and 17.
Okay.
And I will pray the Father shall be given you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him.
Awesome.
But ye shall know him, for he dwelleth with you and shall be in you.
Amen. Thank you. Let me ask you, Ikenna, who is living in us? Say that again. You got a mic? Huh? The Holy Spirit. Amen. Give him a hand clap. That is, you see, when I go, I'm going to come back again. I'm going to give you the comforter, the Holy Spirit. And who is the Holy Spirit? Who's the Holy Spirit, Ikenna? Who's the Holy Spirit? They didn't hear you. Let me give you the mic. Who's the Holy Spirit?
Jesus.
And who is Jesus?
God.
Hallelujah. Amen. Give the whole Lord a hand clap. They know who Jesus is. They know who the Holy Spirit is. One is not greater. He's the self same person doing marvelous things. That's why we can sing. Marvelous you. You are marvelous, Jesus. You are marvelous, 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 Jesus, marvelous, you. He is marvelous, Jesus. You are marvelous, 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 Praise ye the Lord. Now, the next hymn these kids are going to sing to lift him up, because there's no one greater. Is there anyone greater? Anyone higher? All right, kids, will you stand up? They're gonna sing a song. I don't know if you can sit down when they're singing this song. I don't know if you can stand up. I don't know if you can flip over. I don't know if you can afford to even sit down. Amen. All right, all right, all right. Auntie Princessa is going to be on the mic. Yes, it's on that mic. All right.
one that can be crowned king. You know, some people call themselves various titles, which is okay. But he that will be crowned in the final analysis is the King of Kings, is the Lord of Lords. And every Lord has to answer to that Lord. Praise ye the Lord. And at his feet, every knee bow, whether they like it or not. It don't matter. Let him speak colloquial English. It don't matter. Every knee will bow at his feet. Praise the Lord. We thank God that hitherto the Lord has helped us. I don't know if you're here and you don't have a pastor now. I'm not saying you are not going to church, please. You don't have a personal relationship with this King of Kings. If you're just coming to church, it's a wasted exercise. I want you to hold those mics, please. I plead off with you. I implore you, taste and see that the Lord is good. It doesn't matter where you have been. It doesn't matter. What matters is where you're going when the number is called. That each and every one of us who have heard this message, the message of salvation, it may not stand against you. That you may hear those recommendations, those commendations. That's what I live for. It's worth dying for. To hear him say, well done. Well done. You can hear well done from your friends. You can hear well done from your teacher. But to hear well done from Kabies himself, from the Lord of the earth, for him to tell you well done and give you a welcome, it's worth the persecution or the challenges of life. If you want to know more about him, please don't leave this place without having this personal walk. I want to thank each and every one of our parents. You know, it takes a lot. It takes a lot for parents to drive these kids back and forth to practice when they have to pay the bills, but we sure appreciate all of you. God bless you for sending this. I don't take this for granted. Honestly, I don't take it for granted. There are several other things one could be doing, but I'd rather do this to set up the next generation to serve the King. Kids, I think it's time for us to pray. All of you want to stand up and come over here. I want the church to please, all of you kneel down. All of you kneel down. Thank you, thank you. Hallelujah. I want the church to please stand up. This is very important because the Bible says the words that we speak, they are spirit and they are life. Amen? The words that we speak upon these children, that's why it's so important. You don't use bad words to your children or whoever. Let us pray for them. Let us pray for them. Pray for them. I mean, pray for them with all your heart. If there's a gift we could give these children, it's for them to be serving the Lord. Be examples to their generation. To be ambassadors for Christ to their generation. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus' name, faithful God, we give you praise. We worship you. We honor you for these children. You said, let them come unto you, for theirs is the kingdom of God. Father, we thank you for your angels encamped round about these children, protecting and shielding them. The spirit of this age will not overtake them in the name of Jesus. Amen. They shall only hear the voice of God and the voice of God alone. Amen. They will not listen to strange voices. In the name of Jesus. These children shall be for signs and wonder. In the name of Jesus. They will not be prey, you know, to the devil in the name of Jesus. But the righteous seed will be saved in Jesus' name. We cover them in the blood of Jesus Christ. We soak them in the blood of Jesus Christ. No weapon fashioned against them will prosper. Every voice that will rise up against them will be condemned in the name of Jesus. We and the children that the Lord have given us will serve the living God. We will not miss any one of them. We will not miss any one of them. These children will go with us to rapture in the name of Jesus. All the ones that are lost will come back to their home where they belong. In the name of Jesus, there shall be light wherever. All the spirit of depression, we come against it. Demonic spirit of mental illness in any form, in any way, in the name of Jesus, we come against it right now. Every lies of the devil, they will not believe it. But Lord Jesus, spirit of sound mind, spirit of love, spirit of power, in Jesus' name, we come against every spirit of fear, every spirit of anxiety, every spirit of timidity. We come against it right now in Jesus' name. Father, Lord, lead them in the paths of righteousness. They will only walk in the path that you carved out for them. They will never go astray. In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. As it has been spoken and it has been established, so it is in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Did I send you away yet? I know that they have some hangout stuff there. So please, in this last, I'm going to ask David to come back and we'll do that song while we give the offering. Okay? We are a soldier. All right? They are a soldier. I've got to remind them as they go. If you have anything you'd like to give to the work of the ministry, we appreciate it. You know, every dime goes into the work. Everybody here, the ministers and what have you here, they're all volunteers. None of them get paid. They do it because they love the Lord. All right? So please, will you help us? All right. So David, God bless you, buddy.
This is.
When he calls you, may you answer when he calls you. Sometimes you may be sleeping. Sometimes you may get so busy at work and he may call you, just go to the bathroom right now and go pray for Brother Peter. He may call you right now, say, hey, get out of that situation you are at. Your son needs prayer. Your son needs prayer. Your daughter needs prayer. I remember a mother who was praying for her daughter in the Uber transport. The transporter were ready to kidnap her because the mother prayed. Papa prayed. She was clean escaped. She was clean escaped from the snare of the fowler. And she's here with us. Can somebody say amen? I said, and she's here with us. Well, our heads could have been bowed low and crying. You know how many kids? How many kids are taken down into sex trade? But that has not been our portion. To this I give all the glory. To this I give God the glory. Let's just stand up and bless this offering. Please, 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 if you need prayers for anything, there's somebody here who's willing to join you. Where two or three are gathered, he's there in their midst. You don't need to carry this weight by yourself. Find somebody. Find somebody. I can tell you the pastors we have in the house, they're very discreet. Not talkatives. That's the truth. And his words are going to spread around town. Because they are not hirelings. You see, the hireling will run when they go and get stuff. But them that are called and chosen and appointed, they'll be there with the sheep. They lay their life down for the sheep. Praise ye the Lord. Anybody need any prayer? This evening, this morning, just lift your hands up. You don't need to come out here. The Lord is here. Say, where two or three, like kids in red. Five would chase 100. 100 would chase 10,000. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, anybody's hand raised up, he's here. It's that simple. We don't need to see the lightning rod and all that stuff. Fire everywhere. No, he's here because he said so and signed it and sealed it in his blood. Thank you, Father, for your goodness and your mercies over us, for your blood that covers each and every one of us. Without your blood, where would we be? Without you, where would we be? But we thank you for your mercies that are new every morning, for your faithfulness in our unfaithfulness, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ, you died for us. Father, help us not to take it for granted, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Help us to pull somebody up who is down. Not laugh at them. Not to say it serves you right. No. Let us pull them up. To the degree the Lord has helped you, help us, others to that same degree. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for all those that have given something to help us out in this place. Father, meet them at their point of need too, Lord. At their crossroads of life, we are all needy people. We are all needy people. I don't care who you are. I don't care how much money you got. It doesn't matter. There's something for which you need a lifting up. And if you want to be carried like a child, as you go out this week, please join me, lift your hands up. Lift your hands up. Say, Lord, carry me. Lord Jesus, carry me this week. That I be clean escaped from the snare of the fowler, that my extended family may be escaped from the snare of the fowler in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we pray. Your children pray for our brother, Elder James, who's going through challenges. We thank you because you have lifted him above his enemies. You have lifted him on higher ground and he's seated with you. Thank you, Lord, because the work you have started, you perfect it in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for the family. Thank you for the children, for the grandchildren. Thank you, Lord, because we dance and sing again
In the name of Jesus, his clean escaped. His clean escaped in the name of Jesus. Blessed be your name, O Lord. As we go this week, O Lord, you are with us because you said so. You said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. So let it come to pass that to which you have spoken by your very mouth. Let the angels that excel in strength and power execute. Because you said, like the walls around Jerusalem, so you encamp around each and every one of us in the name of Jesus. We will not hear any bad news concerning anybody. In the name of Jesus. Only goodness and mercy and favor will locate us this week in the name of Jesus. Those that drive by road, by car, those that are traveling different places to the north, south, east, and west. Let the angel of God guide them. Guide us. Thou star of David. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We bless this offering. Everyone that has given something. Father, Lord, let it speak for them in the courts of heaven. In the name of Jesus. Like it's your like the giving of Cornelius spoke. Kasim Teriala. Father, let it speak for them in the name of Jesus. Out of that which they have given to your work, Father, replenish their pockets. Run over with others heap to their bosoms in the name of Jesus. The pile of no meal will not waste in the name of Jesus. The cruiser will not finish in the name of Jesus. It will run over, pressed down, shaking together. In the name of Jesus. Not because I said it, because you said it. Let it come to pass. In the name of Jesus. There shall no lack, no one lacking in your midst. In the name of Jesus. You went further to say, Lord, even there shall be no one barren. Spiritually, physically, it shall not be named among us. In the name of Jesus. We shall be fruitful and multiply. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, Lord. We lift up our hands to you, Lord. We give you a wave offering. Give you a wave offering. Come on, lift your hand and give him a wave offering. Say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. As I sing this song, I will part ways. Glory, honor, power, majesty. Unto God, amen. Help me, hallelujah. Pray, oh, no, power, majesty. Be unto Christ, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Ghost with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. God bless you. God keep you. God cause his face to shine upon you. Amen. Kids, I think Uncle Emmanuel was so happy to buy us some pizza. Is that right, Uncle Emmanuel? Huh? Ogwefi, we thank you very much. We thank kids, Pastor Emmanuel, of that pizza for all of you. Okay? So go over there. Huh? Thank you, everybody. God bless you. God cause his face to shine upon you, be merciful to you this week in the name of Jesus. Thank you for bringing my children over here this morning. I appreciate it. Thank you, man of God. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Mama. Hey, sweetheart. Thank you.